ring with. Who's that? It's Silly Billy! Silly Billy has come to fight!
Look at him! He can barely stand! He's so drunk!
I believe he's injured, Mike! I believe he's injured! He's getting in the ring right now! Milo Shizo is down! What are we going to see right here?
If he's too injured, he should not be allowed in this match! The referee already made a decision and took Billy out of this match. What the heck is he doing? The referee... No!
Silly Billy's on the top rope. What are we going to see here?
Oh, he misses! Billy misses. Obviously, he's still too inebriated.
No! Milo Shizo...
headbutt to the ribs. Hooks the leg. One, two, and three! Secret Society have won this match!
Why you lost in January?
Why did you lose in January?
Because of me.
How do you sleep at night?
I wasn't the one in the ring. It was the referee. The referee.
No. Who made the match? Who was undefeated in 2010? Oh, we won.
Yes.
And how do you reward us by putting us in two other tag teams? And then we'll be number one contenders and do it. Good luck, guys.
Look. I've got news for you. I've got news for you, and I've got news for all you out there watching the UWC.
Is it good news?
Yes, it is.
Is it good news for us?
It is great news for you, because right here in my hand, I have the contract. Now, if you read it right there, it says, you guys get the winner of the Unholy Alliance Blackhearted Justice Tag Team title match.
Oh, yeah?
You're the number one contender, boys.
You are not as dumb as you look, man. You're finally giving the fans what they want
Absolutely.
To see. Us as the tag team champions. So, Blackhearted Justice,
Unholy Alliance, the winner.
Whoever wins that match.
You guys face the champion. And then you will become the UWC tag team champion.
That's great. Whoever wins that match.
Yes.
You're a good guy.
I'll hold on to
you. No, you won't. No. We're gonna sign this in the champion's blood.
All right.
And we'll get it back to you.
All right.
Fair enough. Awesome.
Good luck.
All right, get the hell out of my way. Get out. Don't even shake. Get out. We gotta go watch it.
Exciting edition of UWC Championship Wrestling. I'm Chris Wilcox, along with the host of UWC Championship Wrestling, Michael Grimaldi.
Hey, Chris, that's a great shirt. Is that new?
Let's not talk about my attire right here, Mike. We just saw some footage with you and the Secret Society, and I know a couple weeks ago that you said, when I asked you what the deal is with you and them, you said, oh, it's a secret. But we keep seeing all this footage with you and the Secret Society. What's the deal?
Look, Chris, first of all, stop following me around with the stupid camera everywhere I go. It's none of your business the discussions me and the Secret Society have in the back before the matches. So please stop worrying about that. What's the deal with me and the Secret Society? Look, all you have to know is they're fine, upstanding gentlemen, individuals who I am proud to represent the UWC, and individuals who hopefully one day will be the UWC Tag Team Champions.
Well, speaking of the UWC Tag Team Champions, Blackhearted Justice are in action against the Unholy Alliance on this very program. We don't want to waste another minute. We want to show you that match right now. Let's go to the ring.
I hope they both kill each other.
Right.
The UWC Tag Team Championship is on the line right here as the Unholy Alliance before I was so rudely interrupted by Ripper, the Unholy Alliance challenged for the tag team titles here against Blackhearted Justice.
And the match started with a four-way handshake, a lot of show of respect. That's what you'd like to see in the UWC, good sportsmanship.
Well, I don't know if this mutual admiration society is going to last very long. These guys want to be champions, and that's all that should matter here in the UWC.
Once this match starts, it's all out the window. Everybody's going to be trying to win those tag team title belts, and I think both sides understand that.
A big standoff there by Ripper and Justice Garrison. Ryan Blackheart tags in, and here comes Billy Lasseter.
You know, it's been his kinder, gentler Billy Lasseter of late. You know, instead of having that old swastika tattoo, he's changed to an X
episodes, he started to see a little bit of a softer side of Billy Lassiter.
I don't know if I want to see a softer side of Billy Lassiter, but anyway, Blackheart takes Lassiter down, and you know he's got a waist lock. Lassiter reverses it. Nice chain wrestling by Billy Lassiter here.
Not what you'd expect out of Billy Lassiter, but he's trying to do the honorable thing with this match.
Blackheart now sweeps the leg, going for a spinning toe hold.
Both of these teams are very familiar with one another. It was only about a year ago where Blackhearted Justice made their UWC debut against the Unholy Alliance. And worth pointing out, the Unholy Alliance was victorious in that match.
Well, Blackhearted Justice looking to settle the score, and of course the tag team titles are on the line here, so it's all the stakes are whatever.
A lot of stakes on the line right here.
I could go for a stake. I think that's the problem. Blackheart backs Lassiter into the corner. Fires away with right hands to the gut. Lassiter reverses. Blackheart tips up the corner. Lassiter blocks the super kick. Sweeps the leg. Over for the cover. One, two, no.
Only a one count.
Well, referee didn't even get the two that time. Hopefully there won't be any kind of, you know, shenanigans going on with this referee in this match.
It's a championship match. You'd hate to see something like that.
Well, last month, this referee and the tag team match for the number one contendership screwed that up, too, as we got a big backdrop over for the cover ripper.
Only a two count.
Ripper with a big knee lift.
We spoke before about UWC originals. The Unholy Alliance are two of the most original originals. They've been around here since God knows when, and they're one of the top tag teams in UWC.
I believe God created UWC, and then he created the Unholy Alliance. How that makes sense, I don't know. Wait, is he going for a pile driver? No, Ripper!
Big back body drop out of the pile driver.
Show his strength there. Over for the cover. Only a two count. I apologize. The action's so fast and furious here. I'm just completely at a loss for words here.
That was a nice schoolboy roll by Ryan Blackpepper. He's only good for a two count.
Oh, now he fires away with a knife-edge chop.
He better be careful. The Ripper is the king of the knife-edge chop in UWC.
Sends him off. Big belly-to-belly suplex. Shook the ring. Doesn't hook the leg and only gets a two count.
Ryan Blackheart has shown that he can hit that belly-to-belly suplex on just about anybody in the UWC. He's hit it on both members of CB4. He's hit it on T-Bonds. Who can he hit that belly-to-belly suplex on?
I like to see him try to hit it on Legion myself.
We'll have to see if that match ever comes to be.
Garrison down. Up, shoulder tackle. Knocks him down. Ripper off the ropes. Big hip toss. And Ripper bails to the outside. Ryan Blackheart, though, not letting him catch his breath, throws him right back into the ring.
That's what you gotta do when the titles are on the line. You gotta keep it going.
But they're the champions. They can win by count on it if they want. It doesn't matter.
They want to win by pinfall or submission. They want to prove that they're the better team.
Well, they might prove that they're no longer the tag team champions with an attitude like that. Lassiter now tagged in. Has to hold the Garrison.
Looks like we're gonna see a double team move right here.
Whip Garrison into the rope. Oh!
That was a nasty back body drop.
Over for the cover. One, two. No, somehow Garrison kicks out. I have no idea.
He had to dig in deep to kick out of that nasty maneuver.
Well, he might have landed right on the top of his head there. Lassiter now trying to gain control. Clearly he sees that Garrison is injured and he's trying to wear him down.
Crowd chanting Barney in support of the Ripper.
Blackheart trying to get the crowd behind Garrison. We could see that mule kick right to the chest of Lassiter. Now off. Big flying forearm.
He is not letting Billy Lassiter catch his breath even for a second.
Garrison now has Lassiter by the legs. Slams him out of the corner.
Landed right on that lower back.
Lassiter needs to make a tag, but Garrison over for the cover. And the referee somehow saw Lassiter grab the bottom rope, even though he was only 2 feet away.
Lassiter still had the presence of mind to grab the rope and try to break up that two count.
And now Ripper tags back in as you see the veteran wherewithal of the Unholy Alliance.
Ooh.
As Ripper just lights up the chest of Justice Garrison.
You do not want to get into a chop exchange with the Ripper.
No, you don't. Blackheart trying to make the tag.
Look at the Unholy Alliance cut off the ring right now, making frequent tags in and out, trying to keep Justice Garrison on their side of the ring. That's tag team specialist in the ring right now.
Well, you notice Ripper places himself right in between Garrison and Blackheart, so Garrison can't make the tag.
These guys are veterans. They've been around UWC for over 10 years. They know what they're doing in there. They know how to be tag team champions.
If you see Ripper right there, he's sliding his hands over Garrison's mouth and his nose, trying to cut his oxygen off.
But Garrison's able to get out of that nasty jawbreaker right there.
Both men are down. Garrison doesn't look like he knows where he is. He's got to make a tag here, otherwise the tag team titles could be slipping out of the fingers of Blackhearted Justice.
He's in the wrong corner right now, though. He needs to get over to his tag team partner.
Ripper's getting closer. Ripper makes the tag, and here comes Blackheart. Billy Lassiter and Ryan Blackheart are the legal men. Blackheart takes out Lassiter, and then one for Ripper. Ripper into Billy Lassiter, and Ryan Blackheart is all fired up. Big crossbody in the corner. Blackheart now setting him up.
Look at that big suplex.
Brought him down with authority. Over for the cover with the leg hook. No.
Only a two count.
Well, the tag team champions are now seeming to finally find their footing here. They had a slow start to this match, but now they seem to, hopefully Ryan Blackheart can gain control of this match for the team.
It looked like he was going for a rude awakening, but he went with something else on that one, more like a slop drop.
And now Blackheart going up to the middle rope. Now he's all the way to the top.
He doesn't know that Billy Lassiter's on his feet.
Oh, and a low bridge.
Wait, where are you going, Mike? Where are you going? Mike Grimaldi has left the broadcast area, folks. I don't know what's going on right here. Billy Lassiter's got him up. Razor's edge. The Ripper's on the top rope. They look like they're setting up for their finisher. Mike Grimaldi over there is distracting the ref. What is going on right here? Ryan Blackheart is on his feet. Oh, he got hit with a clothesline. The Secret Society are out. What is going on right here? Secret Society's attacking the Ripper. Referee doesn't see it. He just blew mist in his eyes. Billy Lassiter can't see. Ryan Blackheart has the cradle. One, two, three. No, not like that. That was a clean match until that finish. What happened there? Blackhearted Justice has won the match, but Ryan Blackheart, I think, just saw the Secret Society on the outside of the ring. Mike Grimaldi looks like he's in trouble. Ripper has got a piece of him. What is going on out there?
Listen, let me just say this now. Listen, as a man, as a tag team champion, We had absolutely nothing to do with what went on out there. We had no idea what was going down, and we were upset that we had to have our match ruined by interference like that.
We owe you from our first match. That is not how we do things. You know this. We settle things mano a mano, team to team. Hell, I don't even own the match.
We're going to take you at your word. We're not done. We're going to hook up again sometime in the future. All right? We're going to meet up again. Right now, what I'm demanding, what we're demanding, I want, he wants, society in the ring next month in this place, because we're going to end this once and for all. And you know another bit, since I'm going off like a rambling fool, the commissioner, I'm getting tired of it. He keeps sticking his nose in the mat. You know what, pal? Why don't you come down and why don't you face us man to man and we'll have a discussion in the ring?
If he's not managing him,
wow, something's got to be wrong.
Okay, there's so much under the table stuff happening between society and the so-called commissioner. Why don't he just stop coming down with him? You know what? That's it. I'll see you guys. Be good.
Mike, what were you doing at ringside for that tag team championship match? You had no business being at ringside. You were supposed to be doing commentary with me.
Wait, first of all, I'm the commissioner here in UWC. You don't talk to me that way. Secondly, I told you on commentary, the referees here in the UWC have been doing a horrendous job. All I wanted to do was go down to ringside. I saw that the referee had the wrong man in the ring. I was just trying to convey to him that he had the wrong man was in the ring, and I just wanted to give the fans a proper outcome. That's all I wanted to do. Stop accusing me, please.
No fans are happy with that outcome. We don't know who's the rightful winner.
Look, it's not my job to pick the outcome. I just wanted to make sure that the circumstances were fair and correct. That's all I was trying to do. Enough of the accusations, please.
Well, still to come, we do have more wrestling action for you. It's going to be the ladies in singles competition. It's going to be Taylor Nicole Rules taking on Roxie Cotton.
Isn't that a cat scoop on a pole match?
It is not a cat scoop on a pole match. Come on now, let's be serious here.
I'm a broadcast journalist. I thought it was a cat scoop on a pole match. Shoot me.
Before we go off the air tonight, we do want to go over some exciting matches we have coming up for you on our this weekend.
That's right, Chris. This weekend in Browns Mills, New Jersey, at the Firehouse, you're going to see a bunch of great matches. You're going to see the Secret Society taking on Blackhearted Justice for the tag team titles. Now, finally, the uncrowned champions can become the tag team champions.
I don't know about that, but we're going to also have other members of the Secret Society taking on the Unholy Alliance. Mike, who are these other members of the Secret Society that will be facing the Unholy Alliance?
A couple of guys in a mask.
Duh. Well, anyway, we also have a huge main event, one of the biggest main events we've had in quite some time. You're going to see CB4 with their manager, Joe Rules, taking on the former UWC Tag Team Champions, Twiggy Ramirez and The Orphan. Now let's give some comments from Twiggy and The Orphan as we get set for this Saturday night at the Firehouse.
March 15th, the Browns Mill Fire Hall. CB4, you know, you guys are under my skin like nobody's business. You put Biggie Biggs on the shelf? I don't think so. Biggie Biggs will be back. But next month, I got the Orphan tag team action against the former tag team champions. What do you think?
What do I think? This is what I think, Twiggy. I'm sick and tired of these guys running around thinking they're UWC. You're not UWC. We are original UWC. You guys are nothing but a bunch of trumps. You guys are a bunch of punks. We're going to show you what real men are like. Well, you guys think you're real men in the little locker room of yours, whatever you guys do back there, I don't care. But when you step in that ring with us, you're going to see what pain really is, because we are what pain is.
Big Rig and Bubba, you want to jump on? You can't handle the two of us. But we're going to find out in March in Browns Mills, baby.
Taylor Nicole Rules in the ring, and she slaps Joe in the face again. Poor Joe Rules has taken a lot of punishment at the hands of Taylor Nicole. I shouldn't say poor, he deserves every bit of it.
Oh, referee trying to get control as we try to get this match started.
Roxie Cotton still smarting from that slap.
Roxie Cotton looks like she got her outfit from a pack of Smarties. Very smarting.
Very 80s look from Roxie Cotton.
Well, she's rocking out here tonight with Joe Rules, 1984 style.
I guess she wanted a date with Joe Rules, and more power to her.
Does that mean she has to clean the litter box? Anyway, Roxie tries to lock up with Taylor, but she just powers her back into the corner.
Roxie got in a very much of a strength disadvantage here against Taylor Nicole.
Well, Roxie hasn't been here for the UWC for a while. As Joe mentioned, she was involved in that sham where Joe tried to make himself the champion, and Taylor just pushes Joe right in his ample gut.
And he goes right to the outside.
Taylor now with the shots of the midsection, now setting Roxie up for a suplex and takes her over.
Nice vertical suplex by Taylor Nicole.
Roxie now. She used the leverage there. And now here's Joe Rules.
Joe Rules is choking Taylor Nicole on the ropes.
Joe Rules is just telling Taylor Nicole how much he loves her and how on Valentine's Day he expects a nice big box of chocolates from Taylor.
They broke up months ago. She's kicked him out of the house.
Well, she might have kicked him out of the house, but I still think she should get Joe something for being such a magnanimous man.
He's seeing somebody else. He's seeing Roxie. He sees another woman every month.
Listen, Chris. Joe is a player. So don't hate. Roxie now. Ooh, big charging elbow. Builds up a head of steam again. And a second. Off the ropes now. And a big lunging elbow right to the face of Taylor Nicole. And she is down.
She is hurting in the corner right now.
Much to the delight of her former husband, Joe Rules.
But the fans seem to be rallying behind Taylor Nicole Rules. She's a big fan favorite here at the Browns Mills Firehouse.
Browns Mills loves Taylor Nicole. Roxie now. Trying to set Taylor up. What is she going to do? She's got a handful of hair. The referee. Oh, now she apparently decided to let go of Taylor's hair. And now she's doing a number on her from behind.
I think she had her eyes again.
Well, the referee's distracted by Joe Rules. Typical Joe Rules style, distracting the referee, allowing his charge to get the advantage.
Taylor Nicole on the mat right now. Roxie Cotton doing an assortment of illegal activities.
Oh, now she's... Was she leaning on Taylor Nicole's throat?
I believe she was, right with that shin, right across the throat. That cannot be very comfortable for Taylor Nicole.
Well, now she's trying to give the referee instructions. Unfortunately, Roxie, we don't have all night to give these idiot referees instructions.
That should be the job of the commissioner's office, I might add.
Well, when we try... Oh, wait, she could be going for a submission here.
Is that a cross-arm breaker?
Going for the crowbar. She learned this move from the great Brent Albright.
One of the all-time greats, I'm sure.
Roxie now dropping some knees into Taylor Nicole's elbow, trying to hyperextend the elbow.
Working on those ligaments in that right left arm.
Now Roxie's got the referee.
Joe Rules is getting involved again.
Is the referee trying to win a date with Roxie Cotton, or is he a referee? Why isn't he watching this match?
But you saw it, Taylor Nicole got a couple good shots in on Joe Rules.
Well, the referee should stop her from that. Joe Rules isn't even in this match. I don't know why Taylor Nicole's taking cheap shots at him.
Almost a three count right there. Roxie Cotton fell off of Taylor Nicole.
Now she's going for the crossface. Uh-oh, this is not a good move.
Looks like whatever she's doing is very much illegal.
I think she's pulling the hair.
It's hard to tell from this vantage point.
Oh, now she's going for the cover. Hooks the leg. Only two. Taylor Nicole kicks out.
Roxie Cotton looks frustrated at her inability to put away Taylor Nicole.
Well, Roxie now just... I think she's lost it.
I think that's what happens when you win a date with Joe Rules. You have to have lost your mind.
Well, Roxie now back with the crossface. Trying to lock it in. Taylor with the roll-up. Only two.
Just kicked out at the nick of time.
Roxie now apparently not happy with this Browns Mills crowd. Who could be? As she pounds away at Taylor Nicole, but Taylor fires back, sends her off the ropes. Double clothesline. Both women are down, and the referee looks to start a 10 count.
Who do you think took the worst of that? I think Roxie Cotton might have been on the worst end of that one.
I think she was, just because she seemed to leave the mat and she landed hard on the canvas. She might have hit the back of her head.
Now Taylor Nicole trying to get the crowd on their feet, and they are responding.
The crowd is coming alive for Taylor Nicole.
The crowd is like Peter Frampton. They're coming alive.
Taylor fights back. They're exchanging blows. Taylor seems to have gotten the upper hand here. Sends Roxie to the near side.
Sidewalk slam!
Cover. One, two, and no!
She's had a lot of success with that move in the past. She beat Joe Rules with that move.
Well, Roxie somehow, while they're kicking out, maybe Joe Rules told her the secret to how to kick out of it. Maybe he finally figured it out after he lost. I don't know. Here comes Taylor Nicole. Misses the big bull rush. Over for the cover.
She's got a handful of tights and the referee sees it.
Well, that's the first time all night the referee's actually done something right. Roxie now shoving the referee. Referee ducks the clothesline. Big slam. Over for the cover. Roxie could be out. Taylor now. No, she's not going for the cover. Uh-oh. Could it be the Billy Goat's curse? Taylor Nicole. Trying to lock it in.
She taps out.
Roxie Cotton taps. Taylor Nicole has defeated another one of Joe Rules' women of the night.
Taylor Nicole Rules is your winner in impressive fashion here at the Browns Mills Firehouse.
Well, I don't know how much of a fun date Roxie Cotton's going to be for Joe Rules tonight. All I know is you better have some extra litter and a giant scoop, because Taylor Nicole's left a whole lot of it for him when he gets home.
Taylor Nicole Rules is your winner here on UWC Championship Wrestling.